You are watching All Things Real Estate and More with Ann-Riley Caldwell, with a brand new episode on Homeowners Insurance.
Hey, I'm Ann-Riley Caldwell, and I am a local Nashville, Middle Tennessee realtor, and we are back with another episode about all things real estate. And today we're here with Kevin Clingan of Clingan Insurance Group, and we're going to be talking about a lot of different things related to homeowner policies and insurance. And so one of the things, we're just going to give you kind of a quick overview of the four main areas that those policies cover, and therefore why they would be important for you to have them.
Yeah, we have 3 or 4 hours to talk about this, right?
No,
no, your homeowner's policy, it is broken down to four main parts. Your first part is your dwelling coverage, and the dwelling coverage really is the insurance coverage to replace the home structure.
Okay.
So if it is blown away by a tornado, or if it's consumed by a fire, what will it cost to replace that building, the building piece of it? The second piece of that is going to be your personal contents, your personal property coverage.
Okay.
And so if you think about having a home, and if you turn the home upside down and shook it, everything that falls out is your personal property.
Oh, that's good.
The structure itself is not covered under personal property, but your furniture, your clothes, your silverware, your rugs, your all of that stuff that would fall out if you shook it, that's your personal property coverage. The third area is going to be your liability coverage. And so we all know that today's there's a pretty litigious environment, and somebody wants somebody to pay if they get hurt. And if that happens on your property, then you're responsible for that. A trampoline, for example, if someone is bouncing on your trampoline and they break their leg, well, you're probably going to be liable for that. And so you're going to have a liability coverage, and that's going to be the hundreds of thousands, 250 or 300 or 500,000. Personally, in our agency, we write nothing less than $250,000 of liability coverage, just because I think that's prudent. Your fourth area is going to be your medical coverage. So if somebody does get hurt on your property, then there is a portion of your policy that covers medical expenses up to, and it'll be a relatively small number, $1,000, $5,000. Those are the four primary. Now there's separate structures in there that will cover fences and cover sheds and things like that to rebuild them. And you can have an extended liability cover, but those are the exception, not necessarily the rule. But the four main areas are going to be your dwelling coverage, going to be your personal property, going to be your liability coverage, and going to be your medical coverage. And all of those will always be in the policy as it's written, and you don't have to add those on.
Okay, so those are basically the standard things that come with every policy.
Right. Now, within each one of those, you will have varying amounts that you can purchase.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Got you. And so it's very important, obviously. And also, if you have a loan, you're going to have homeowners insurance because the lender is going to require it.
Right.
But even if you're not required, and even if for some reason you're going to have a home for even just a short period of time, anything can happen at any time. So you're always going to want to make sure you're covered.
Yeah, absolutely. And I don't know if we want to get into this now, but there is a difference in the dwelling coverage and the purchase price, because your dwelling coverage is what's going to cost to rebuild the structure. You don't have to rebuild the dirt. The lot is there, and you don't have to replace it. And as you know, location, right? So the dirt is going to be a pretty significant portion of the purchase price, but it's not a consideration when you're rebuilding the home on that dirt.
Okay, so we're just looking at the structure and building the structure.
Right.
Yep, so that's good. So when you call Kevin and you want to talk about home insurance, you're going to ask a whole bunch of questions and find out about the size of the home and what the home is made out of, and estimate what the replacement value, what the replacement cost is going to be to basically have it rebuilt. Right?
Rebuilt as it is.
Because
as you know, when you're rebuilding a house, it's just like a car. There, you can have a shell and it costs the same as the next door, but when you start putting in tile versus carpet, when you start putting in granite countertops versus formica, the cost differences are there. And you want to make sure that your homeowner's coverage considers all of those unique characteristics of your home to make sure that it can be replaced as you have it now.
Okay. very important.
Yes.
So yeah, make sure whatever agent you're talking to, should it not be Kevin for some crazy reason, just make sure that they're asking all those questions
right,
and not just making assumptions about what that replacement would look like.
We hope you enjoyed watching All Things Real Estate and More with Ann-Riley Caldwell. To learn more about Ann-Riley or for your real estate needs, visit notyourordinaryagent.com or call 615-930-0313. Thanks for watching.